Hello students, welcome to Wisdom Academy. Today we will be continuing the matter in our surroundings chapter, in which we will be seeing three topics, that is effect of temperature, effect of pressure and interconversion between the states of matter. Here first we will start with effect of change in temperature. Before getting into this topic, we need to know some terminology like boiling point, melting point, latent heat of fusion, latent heat of vaporization. First we will see melting point. It is a temperature in which solid changes into its liquid form under atmospheric pressure. This is called melting point. It is a temperature in which solid is converted into liquid form in its atmospheric pressure, whereas boiling point is again the temperature in which the liquid is converted into gas in atmospheric pressure. So melting point, solid is converted into liquid. Boiling point, liquid is converted into gas. And there is something called latent heat of fusion, LHF, latent heat of fusion. It is the amount of heat energy required to convert 1 kg of solid to liquid in atmospheric pressure in its melting point. So here 1 kg of solid is converted into liquid. Then how much amount of heat energy is required for this particular conversion? One particular important condition is there should be atmospheric pressure, and that should occur in the particular melting point. Then there is something called latent heat of vaporization. The same thing, 1 liter of liquid is converted into gas. Then how much heat energy is required for this under atmospheric pressure in its boiling point? This is called latent heat of vaporization. So these 4 terminologies you should be knowing before getting into the topic. Now we will see how will you interconvert these 3 states of matter by changing the temperature. So basically we take water as example. In room temperature it is liquid, in 0 degree Celsius it is solid, and above boiling point it is gas. So these are 3 forms or 3 state of matter of water. Now we take solid, that is ice, to liquid, it is water. Now how will you convert ice to water is heat. You just heat it. But how will you convert water to ice is by cooling. So this ice and water can be interconverted. Ice to water we need to heat the system, where water to ice is we need to cool it. Then it is gas, that is water vapor. Again here liquid is converted to gas by heating, whereas gas is again converted to liquid by a form cooling. So this are the effect of temperature on the 3 states of matter. So solid to liquid, heat. Liquid to gas, heat. Reverse process, gas to liquid, cool. Liquid to solid, cool. So this is the effect of temperature on the states of matter. The next thing is effect of pressure. So now how will you conclude effect of pressure is, we have already seen the characteristic nature of states of matter. When we apply pressure, say some particles are there and we apply pressure, the intermolecular force or interparticle force will decrease. When the interparticle force or intermolecular force is different from the initial one, the state of matter, for example, solid has very less space, liquid has somewhat space, gas has more space. So when the pressure changes, the state of matter also will change. So this is the effect of pressure. Now we will have a like idea how will you convert gas to liquid. So how will you convert gas to liquid is, we need to maintain 2 important conditions, that is increased pressure, temperature should be low. So there are 2 conditions in which gas can be converted to liquid. Pressure should be high, temperature should be low. Whereas again we can reverse it, liquid to gas, pressure should be low, temperature should be high. So this two system can be interconnected by using the temperature and pressure terms. So for example, we take carbon dioxide, which is a gas in room temperature, can be converted into dry ice, which is solid form. That is liquid that is converted into a dry ice solid form. So here we need to maintain it as pressure as a high pressure as high and temperature in a low value. So this is how will you convert it. So the next one is interconversion of states of matter. So we have a cyclic diagram for that. So how will you convert and what is the process of converting from one state of matter to the other one? Liquid, solid, gas. Now the process of converting solid to liquid is called fusion, whereas liquid to solid is called solidification. Here liquid to gas is called vaporization, gas to liquid is called condensation. You need to see the opposite process: vaporization, condensation, fusion, solidification. And here gas to solid both are called sublimation. Sublimation is a process in which gas is converted into solid. This process is quite rare, but the above process, the solid can be easily converted to gas. For example, camphor, we have camphor which is very volatile. That is, when you place camphor outside, after some time it will be converted into vapor form. That is one example. Then for this form we have ice, water and vapor phase. That is water vapor. So these are the six process of interconversion of states of matter: solid to liquid, liquid to gas, gas to solid. Our last one topic is evaporation. Now there is difference between evaporation and boiling point. What boiling point is? It is a temperature. It is a temperature in which liquid is converted into gas at atmospheric pressure. But what evaporation? It is a phenomena in which liquid is converted to gas below its boiling point. The main condition is the particular temperature should be, or particular process should be, below the boiling point of the liquid we have taken. So this is called evaporation. In evaporation there are many factors which affect the evaporation process. For example, surface area. For example, I have some beaker like this and I have another vessel like this. What is surface area? Is the outer part. It's called surface area. In this two system, this have less surface area and this have more surface area. So obviously evaporation of this system will be high because the surface area is more. The next one is temperature. When temperature increases, evaporation increases, because when temperature increases kinetic energy increases. We have already seen this. When kinetic energy increases, particles will move randomly, so they are easy for liquid phase to get easily convert into gaseous phase. So the first one we saw is surface area, second one is kinetic energy. The next one is humidity. Now what is humidity? Is the amount of water vapor present in the atmosphere. For example, we have a system here and this is the surroundings. If the surroundings has water vapor, the water vapor produced in the system will be low, okay, because the surroundings already has water vapor, so the system cannot produce more water vapor in it. So when humidity is high, evaporation will be less. So finally we need less humidity for more evaporation. The last one is wind speed. When there is more wind, all the water vapor will be surrounding the system, will not affect the system. So obviously the liquid can easily convert it into water vapor. So what is evaporation? Is liquid is converted to gaseous form, that is vapor form, below its boiling point. So because of humidity there was water vapor which is not favoring evaporation, but later on when there is wind, with high speed, there will be no water vapor surrounding the system. So obviously it is very easy for liquid to get into the gaseous form. So the four condition: more surface area, high temperature, less humidity, high wind speed. These are the four factors which affects the evaporation. So the last one is two application part, like how, why we have to wear cotton in summer and why there are water droplets when we have water in a glass. Okay, so first one we'll take cotton example. Cotton is a very good absorber of water. Okay, for example, we take, this is our tissue, this is our muscle, and we wear cotton. Okay, and this is cotton. We wear cotton, all the sweat in our body will be absorbed by cotton. When we have sweat, that is liquid in cotton, the liquid, what will it will do is, the liquid will be converted into gaseous form. Now, to convert liquid into gaseous form, the liquid needs some energy. The energy is absorbed from the surroundings. The energy is absorbed from the surroundings. So when the heat energy moves from muscle to cotton, the heat energy in muscle is less. When the heat is less, there will be cool in the muscle region. So whenever the heat is absorbed from this, that is removed from the system will have cooling effect. So when the cotton removes the sweat acts as, that is liquid, will remove the heat energy to convert it into gas. So when the heat is removed from the muscle, we have the cooling effect. So this is the reason why cotton is recommended during summer days. The next one is water droplet on the outer surface of the glass containing ice cold water. We have some water, like it's very chill, and we face some water droplets. Okay, so the why, the reason of water again water droplet here is, water vapor present in the atmosphere when come in contact with this, it will convert into liquid phase, because it is very, this is a reverse process. The gas form, when it is cool, is converted into liquid phase. So okay, the liquid phase will convert into droplets. This is the reason. We have already seen liquid to gas is heat, where gas to liquid is cool. The cooling effect takes place here. The water vapor, because of the cooling nature, will come and stick as the liquid drops. So gas is converted into liquid here. So finally, we will find some droplets that is attached to the glass containing ice cold water. So in this session, we have seen the effect of temperature and pressure on states of matter and the interconversion between them. Then we saw what is evaporation and the cooling effect of evaporation. Thank you. Like the video, subscribe our channel, share with your friends.